Not you as well. Tell me it ain't you as well,
hey,
you
hey,
Slavic
hey.
Fuck!
What are you talking about?
Speak, you Balkan piece of shit! I'm done with you, done with everyone. I'll go, but I ain't going quietly!
Mr. Pegorino, I don't know what you're talking about. I came as quickly as I could.
Fucking Anthony!
What about Anthony?
He was wearing a fucking wire!
That is a problem.
My personal bodyguard wearing a wire! I raised that kid like he was my own! I beat him like he was my own son! When my son killed himself, Anthony became my son. Now this! The world is a cunt!
Where is Anthony?
I heard he's wearing a wire. So I freak out. I call him up. He's such a moron, he leaves his cell phone on. So we speak. After he's gone states, of course. I mean, Jesus. What a chump! He freaks out on the phone. And I put the fear of God in him. I think maybe I've talked him out of it. Then, he has a goddamn heart attack on the phone. I'm thinking problem solved. He's dying right in front of my ears. But the asshole lived, and now he's in the Leftwood Hospital under heavy guard!
Okay, okay.
Of course he's got you on the fucking tape, too!
Of course.
So you'll do this for me.
So you want me to talk to him?
I want you to whack him! And after that, I want you to kill all the other rats I surround myself
okay.
with!
Okay. Okay, don't worry.
You're not like the other surgeons here. You don't have that, you know, God complex thingy.
I guess it's my bedside manner.
John, you're terrible.
Hey, you can't go past here.
Anyone flatlines from here in?
I got Here we go!
You should have kept your fat mouth shut.
LCPD, don't move!
Next time, stay away from me! I don't think you will be seeing Anthony on the witness stand.
I better not be seeing you up there either. Or anybody else I know for that matter. This fucking bitch turning everybody into rats. Stay around, Niko.
Isn't it shit?
Niko, it's finally official. Since the moment I met Mallory, I knew that she was the only woman for me.
Apart from those other ones you screw, right?
No, certainly not. They were just distractions from my one true love. I proposed to Mallory, Niko. She said she would marry me. Now all we need is to find you a wife, and we can all settle down happily ever after.
I'm working on it, cousin. There's this girl I like. She's called Kate McCreary.
I'll invite her to the wedding!
You don't even know her, Roman, so please, try not to embarrass me. Congratulations on the engagement.
Thank you, cousin!
Okay, I'll see you later.
Yeah, okay.
You take care now.
I'll see you later. Give me a call.
Hey. It's not what it looks like.
Okay.
It's not like that. We talk. So do us all a favor and keep quiet.
Sure. But Phil, and I don't mean to take advantage, but maybe I need help on time. Maybe I can give you a call.
What do you mean?
I mean, I need to find something out about someone. Maybe you can help.
Are you fucking blackmailing me?
No! I'm asking for a favor. Why do you think I put my neck on the line for you? Because I need help with something.
You know, since you don't look like you're full of crap, how could I say no? Enough of this chit-chat. Come on, let's go.
We're heading back up to that old house off Beaverhead Avenue in West Dyke. It's about time to pick up that H that my nephew's been sitting.
It's just been sitting there?
Yeah, call it a cooling off period. We took it, but we don't know who was watching it beforehand.
So you just left it with Frankie?
Yeah, we put it in an isolated place. Hopefully any attention it was getting would be noticed. Frankie's one guy, he can disappear real easy if the feds show. Plus, he's a smart kid. He's related to my ex-wife, and she was smart enough to rule my life with one lawsuit.
So it's been long enough. You think we're going to be okay to pick it up? No trouble?
Look, I don't ever assume something's gonna go down easy without any trouble. That's what keeps me alive and out of the pen. We'll see when we get there.
As long as we don't see any helicopters, vans, suspicious gardeners talking into earpieces. If none of that's going on, then we're okay.
Yeah, you fucking laugh. Laugh all you want.
There you are.
Frankie, you've been keeping your eyes open out here. You seen anyone snooping around?
I ain't seen a soul, boss. It's a ghost house. I got the horse loaded into two cars for you.
I don't know, this don't feel right.
Shit, Frankie, you dumb fuck! The feds have been watching us all along. Niko, get in that car and follow me.
The feds don't fuck with the boys and get away with it. Get close to them! Eat this, pigs!
Are you fucking blind? You don't know this to 55th watching these cars. I thought Phil was just paranoid.
Give me a break, man. I got a lot on my mind, you know? I didn't have much time to scope this out. My ma's kinda sick. I've been looking after her. And my sister? I've been putting her through college.
Shut up! These feds are all over me.
I'm sorry, man. It's just, I only got married the other day. God, I love that kid. You want to see a picture?
I don't want to see a fucking picture. I'm trying to get us out of this situation. Maybe then you can spend time with your wife instead of some jailhouse bitch.
They're all over the force, Niko!
They're all over us. We're ditching the cars and going on foot. Park up behind me when I stop.
All right.
Frankie, Niko, grab the stuff from the trunk and follow me. I got a van we could use. More fucking bacon, shit! Cops ain't flipping me if I'm caught, and they better not flip you either. Damn, this is a wild ride. I didn't think I was gonna come out of that one.
You're fucking lucky that you did. Lucky any of us did.
Don't I know it, Phil. I should have seen him. I've been telling Niko I got a lot on my mind.
Next time, mind on the job. This ain't a fucking joke. I don't think I can take much more of this. You got a wife? You got a ma? Don't play around with your life.
Don't play around with other people's lives either. I don't want to take a bullet or a stint in the pen for anyone else's fuck-up.
All right, guys. Shit, I'm sorry.
Niko, you've done good for me. There's been some fucked-up shit going on, but you've been keeping cool. You're a good
I got respect for you.
Hey, let's see if we get back before you start talking like this, shall we? This ain't over until we got the H in the safe place.
You're damn right. Nice driving, Niko. We're gonna be able to shift this H for a lot of money. Might just keep the Pecorino family's head above water. See you around.
I'm looking to earn some money, friend.
There's a file for you, brother. A quick, smooth job like the last one is what we need. It's three men. They've been lured to an old building in Alderney City. Finish them there.
He's working for a living...
Time here.
kids. What's up, Bernie?
I wanted to give you something to say thank you for me and Bryce. Well, he doesn't know I'm giving you this, but he gave it to me, so it's technically from him.
What is it?
This car. Enjoy! I only power walk or take cabs, so I figured I should pass this on to my savior.
Thanks, man. I appreciate that.
Don't mention it. What we've got is worth more than money.
Thank you, Bryce Dawkins. I hope the cash for this didn't come out of city funds.
Let's do it.
Why should we pay just because we said
this is control? We have a criminal attempting to steal a car on Beaverhead Avenue, Middle Park East.
The problem with these guys, I can't even think straight.
So he's always there. He is. Welcome to the war, Counselor, my boy.
Gentlemen. What's going on?
Nothing. Discussing pest control.
Well, I've given you my advice, Peg. You do what you think is best.
I agree.
Finally.
I mean, I don't agree with what he says. I agree that you know best.
Excuse me?
Relax. I didn't mean nothing by it. Look, either we make the right call or we all end up in prison anyway. Well, your crap ain't gonna do me no favors.
Be careful. See you later. Boss, gentlemen.
You're only an associate, Phil. Remember that.
Yeah. Okay, tough
boss,
guy.
I gotta tell you this. He's not straight. Right before I came in here, I saw him talking to Angie again.
You better leave. I need to speak to Niko.
Sure, boss. But, think about what I said.
I will.
You know?
Trust me on that. We got real problems. Police are all over us. Maybe you heard, I got served papers today. Phil, yesterday. We got a couple of boys in jail. I think they might squeal. Somebody's talking. Wants us out of the picture. Maybe John Gravelli. Or them Ancelotti's. Somebody got to my people.
So what are you going to do about it?
I don't know. I gotta shut someone up and show people I mean business. I've known Phil a long time. He's straight, more or less. I know him and Angie are friends, but that don't worry me too much. Maybe he's too straight. Then there's Ray. I don't know. I don't trust him. But he's a good earner. I know he's got his eye on the big prize, but he's no dummy. Him and Phil hate each other. I gotta think about it.
Okay.
I'll give you a call. Whoever I say to go see him. And shut him up!
I want you to pay our friend Ray a visit. Give him a message from me. He's gotta sit down on Card Row and eat off.
If that's your decision, Mr. Pecorino, it's done.
Motherfucker! Holy smack!
I see his car.
He should be heading over to a chop shop in Boabo. Don't get too comfortable with him, Niko. Like every rat, he's a survivor. He's got good instincts. He has a bad feeling about you in particular. He bought some protection and he ain't gonna hang around and wait for you know what to happen. Then again, I'll get his chump muscle to stop for gas out of the way. It might create a good opportunity for you.
The meeting went to plan, Mr. Pecorino.
Clean and out is a tough job, Bellic. I don't got much left in mind if so clean. I'll talk to you soon.